Thomas the Tank Engine and Friends, Wooden Railway Adventures, Episode 237, Knock It Off, Stanley. Rosie's recent makeover had been a big success. Everywhere she went, the engines couldn't believe their former pink friend was now bright red and raring to go. The engines in the yard especially took notice.
You know, I've been thinking, and believe me, this was way in my head before Rosie ever mentioned it, so don't think I'm copying her.
You want to go get a makeover too?
Asked Billy.
Yes, I really, really do. Look at her. Everyone's always so excited to see her and talk to her. She's much more productive as well. She shunts like a million trains a day. Oh, what I wouldn't give to be like her.
Stafford rolled his eyes.
Philip, you don't need to go do something like that. There's no other engine on the railway like you. Remember when those mainland diesels tried to get you to repaint yourself? Going around trying to be something you're not will only get you into trouble.
But strangely, Philip's words began to have an effect on Stanley. Over the next few days, he became obsessed with going to the works and changing something about him.
Maybe if my dome was a little bit shinier, he whispered, or if my bunker was bigger, then I could go on longer journeys. Maybe Victor could replace my wheels with some stronger ones. Then I could shunt bigger and heavier trains.
The next day, he saw Sir Topham Hatt in the yard.
Ooh, hello, sir. I have something very urgent to ask you.
Oh, yes. Hello, Stanley. What is it?
Well, you see, it's a bit of a strange request. Recently, I've been feeling rather down, and I was thinking and wondering and hoping that I could go to the steamworks and maybe get a few parts and pieces replaced. It is almost time for my annual checkup.
Sir Topham Hatt stared blankly back.
We don't do annual checkups, Stanley. What is this all about?
Well, I think I might have a crack in one of my wheels. Maybe Victor should take a look at them.
Sir Topham Hatt looked around.
None of your wheels looked cracked to me.
But you are getting old, sir.
I beg your pardon. I mean, your eyesight. It isn't what it used to be. Perhaps I should go to Victor for a second opinion?
Oh, fine. Just make sure. But then there was trouble.
Help, sir! Help! Oh, no!
Winston! Stanley, we'll pick this conversation up later. Winston, hang on!
Stanley was very happy. Perfect. Now it's off to the steamworks for a new makeover. But when Stanley arrived, Victor was nowhere to be found.
I swear, if I don't get out of here in the next few days...
Hey, Vinny, have you seen Victor recently?
Oh, he just left with a new coach or something. I tell ya, I've been here...
Yeah, that's great and all. Is Kevin around? I have some urgent repairs that need to be administered right away.
No, that Kevin kid ain't here. But guess what? I'm in charge of the steamworks.
Stanley laughed. Yeah, okay, sure. Nice one, Vinny.
No, I'm serious. Before Victor left, he put me in charge. Right, fellas?
Yes, but...
There you have it. I'm in charge of the steamworks. Now what seems to be the matter?
Stanley wasn't so sure. Vinny doesn't know anything about giving upgrades to engines. But Victor is such a stickler, and I don't think he would approve anything I wanted to do. Oh well, I guess this is my shot. Stanley began to explain what he wanted.
Oh, so some cosmetic repairs. Gotcha. I've been hanging around this joint for so long that I know just what Victor would do in a situation like this. We'll even give you a number. How does that sound?
That's wonderful. Look out, Sodor. Rosie isn't going to be the only fresh new engine on the railway.
Vinny had the workmen start on Stanley right away. In no time at all, the modifications were complete.
Well, how do I look?
Marvelous, I tell ya, marvelous. Boy, Vinny, you sure did a good job. You've got a knack for this designing thing.
The workmen, on the other hand, were not so convinced. Listen, Stanley, this has been fun and all, but we better get you back to looking the way you were before. Why? What's wrong? I don't look too different, just a few changes here and there. It's no more than what Victor did to Rosie. Fine, go out there, Stanley, but we warned you.
Great, time for Sodor to meet the new Stanley.
He'll be back in 30 minutes, mark my words.
Meanwhile, Stanley was excited to show his friends what he looked like. This will catch them by surprise, I know it will.
Hey, Stanley, we were wondering where you went.
Oh my goodness, what happened?
Stanley, you look completely different.
Yes, Rosie, I know. I saw how successful your makeover was and decided to go get one myself.
But Stafford was horrified.
Stanley, did Victor do this with his eyes closed?
Oh, come on. It's not that bad.
Look, here comes Philip. He doesn't mince words. He'll tell me exactly how I look.
Hey, Philip.
Oh, no! Stanley's been injured in a horrible accident. We must get you off to the steamworks for repairs immediately.
Stanley blinked slowly.
Okay, maybe a few changes need to be made.
Oh, knock it off, Stanley. It hurts me to say this, but I'm your friend, and friends don't let each other run around looking like this. I'm sorry, but you don't look very good. I don't know what happened at the steamworks, but you need to go back there and ask for a refund.
The steamworks did this to you? Oh my word! Why, Victor would take out his frustrations on an engine I will never know.
Stanley began to realize his makeover had been a complete failure.
Oh, bother, he groaned. I was only trying to be different. After you got a new coat of paint, I figured I could look something like that too. I guess it was a bad idea to let Vinny handle this.
Vinny was behind this?
Well, that makes a lot more sense. I knew Victor wouldn't do this to an engine on purpose.
Stanley puffed sadly away to the steamworks. It was morning when he arrived.
Oh my, Stanley. What has happened to you?
Never mind, we must fix this right away.
Sorry, Victor. I guess I got caught up in trying to make myself look better. Now I've wasted all this time and parts and pieces.
No worries, my friend. Fortunately, the damage isn't too bad. My workmen will return you to your former self in no time.
And Victor was right. Since Vinny didn't know what he was doing, the old changes were quickly erased, and Stanley was back to being himself in no time.
Let this be a lesson to you. You're fine just the way you are. But if you ever do feel the itch to try something new, come find me or Kevin. Not him.
Aw, and I was thinking I did a good job, too.
Stanley was feeling much better, and he quickly puffed back to the yard where his friends were waiting.
It's good to have you back, Stanley. The real Stanley. You got that right. I don't know what I was thinking, but thank you for telling me it was wrong as soon as you did. I couldn't imagine running around the railway looking like that for everyone to see. Let's keep this disaster between the four of us, okay? The engines happily agreed. They were beyond thrilled to have Stanley back and looking like a proper Sodor engine.